lot of them.
Also, the folks at home are very suspicious about dry leaves on a spaceship. Yes, yes. We all are, but that's the universe, what you can say. You know?
We also have a funny story about Luca during a demo match. Luca killed the publisher that was evaluating the game.
Okay, I understand we have some special guests. Well, we always have some special guests, let's be honest here. But
they are old friends. When I was in Cranic Creation, we made our second game was Escape from the Aliens in Outer Space. That is the game that we're going to play. All the Santa Ragione team.
Hello, everyone. Thank you.
Hello, everyone.
Hi, all. Everyone.
Hello, everybody.
So yeah, Santa Ragione is the name of our studio, which we founded in 2010. We're mostly a video game company. But we started off making this board game with you guys back in the day. This is actually our 10th anniversary of the publishing of the game. So when we first launched it together, it was 10 years ago. So we thought it would be cool to play it again.
A great way to celebrate. The game we play today is your first board game. And it's called Escape from the Aliens in Outer Space.
It's an homage to 80s sci-fi movies. You know, they had this like very long and very strange titles.
It's a hidden role game. We are on a spaceship. We can be humans or aliens, and the humans have to reach one of the four exits that are numbers 1, 2, 3, and 4. And if you are alien, you will have to find and kill the humans before they escape. So we will be divided into teams. We have no idea what will be the teams. So I just hope not to be in the same team as Hjalmar.
I'm human. Okay.
During the game, we will use these colored hexagons to remind every sound we produce during the game.
There is silence. Silence. You can't hear anything.
Every gray sector is a danger.
Oh, well, that's a pretty shitty spaceship.
You hear a noise in M08.
That's all not true.
M08, okay.
What is that makes it dangerous?
Dry leaves on the floor that crackle as you step on them. It's on me.
Dry leaves, that sounds like something you can find actually on a spaceship, yes.
Yeah, definitely.
Typical. The main idea comes from Alien, the movie, of course. The idea behind the game was to reproduce this environment and this kind of anxiety and fear sensation. Initially, we were planning to have two different overlapping maps because we wanted the aliens to move inside air conduct like it happens in the movie, you know, and the humans could only move into the corridors of the ship. And this was the original concept that then eventually became a single map with different tiles.
And dry leaves.
A lot of them.
And also, the folks at home are very suspicious about dry leaves on a spaceship. Yes, yes. We all are, but that's the universe, what you can say. You know? You don't go around criticizing Star Wars because they have lightsaber. We have dry leaves. That's it.
It's canon.
Yes, now it's canon.
Everything was more a research to find a specific feeling that came from the movies, right?
Keep in mind, none of us are seasoned board game players. I wouldn't want to say that we've never played a board game before making this one, because of course we did, but we were certainly not, none of us was into board games or like very knowledgeable or very passionate about board games. It's my turn. Sorry, I'm speaking.
It's very easy to see this orange, red, purple.
Yeah, the difference is it's really.
Was it balancing an issue during the develop of the game?
Yes. That's the right answer. Yes. Yeah, it was quite difficult to be in balance here also because you want to keep the tension high and you want to try to have as much as possible this idea that everybody is invisible to the other, what they actually are. And actually at the beginning we had like 300 cards in our deck or something like that.
Wow. Yes, I heard that.
Actually that connected with the fact that you want to keep as secret as possible the identity of everybody and just play on it also talking while you're playing, it made it really difficult to have a balanced deck of cards that can allow you to do that.
Because that was before we met Lorenzo. When we played the prototype with Lorenzo, one of the first things that came out was, guys, you cannot have this amount of card.
We were really poor at the time.
Also. Yes.
Oh, man.
We are still poor, man.
Yeah. To say a couple more things about that question on balancing, kind of goes back to what Nicola was saying at the beginning, that we wanted to achieve a certain feeling before necessarily a system or a mechanic. And so what happened is that we knew that, you know, humans had to go for themselves. They couldn't play really as a team because each human wins on their own when they play the game. So, of course, they feel like the game is unbalanced because the aliens play together to hunt all the humans. They're even competing amongst them to reach the exits. That kind of like purposeful unbalancing taps into that need of achieving a certain feeling for the game.
I'm gonna declare an attack.
No, you're not gonna do it.
I'm dropping an attack in N09. So whoever human or alien is sitting in there, it's to be considered dead meat.
Is there someone in A09, guys?
No.
No. Shame.
Risky business.
Yes!
Luca is an alien.
Luca is an alien. Luca is an alien.
Looks like an alien.
I will attack 07.
Let's go with the attack.
Is there someone?
Is someone there?
Drop the bomb.
Nobody?
Nobody.
Nobody.
Okay.
You hear a noise in I-08.
No, oh, come on.
What?
There's a party.
Is he joking, really?
It's against any COVID rules.
Okay.
Alessandro says, a person with so many H letters in their name cannot be human. I knew it. Hjalmar, I have a feeling he's talking about you.
I mean, human starts with an H.
Like, if I remember correctly, in the prototype, we had text on cards.
Yes.
And that was a problem with localization. And so we removed it. So we created text-free deck.
Yeah, well, that's one way to solve it.
But actually, then we found a way to include the symbols in the sheets you have on the maps. And so you don't have to pick up the manual, but you can always see all these symbols with you.
There are also many different maps. We are playing on the traditional map, but there are many, many other maps. You also created an online tool to create
maps. Yes. Maps,
right?
Oh. Mm-hmm.
We did it with Flash, which is basically means now it's dead. Actually, it's going to be dead in 1 month and a half.
It's still there.
It's still there. Pretty good. It's still available on the website.
Yeah, the time was pretty new. Like, we had to write it on the box that there was an online editor. It was a pretty weird thing. It was a new thing people weren't doing. And someone in the community, like on Board Game Geek, has made an HTML5 version of the editor that works. So you've got to check that out.
There are a lot of roll and write, pen and paper games today, right? There is like an explosion of those. But back in the days, it was not like that. Did you play something similar?
Actually, the fact that it's pen and paper, it was an issue back then. Because before meeting Lorenzo Silva and what was Cranio Creation back then, we tried to go to other Italian publishers, and everybody was really thrown off by the fact that it was a pen and paper game. Everybody was saying, this genre, it's not on the market anymore. We don't think it's going to work.
Too old.
Yeah, everybody was asking for, where are the miniatures? Where is the tabletop? Like,
yeah.
Where is the board game part?
Okay. We also have a funny story about Luca during a demo match. Luca killed a publisher that was evaluating the game on the third round.
Well, he killed him in the game, folks. So, be calm.
And if I'm not wrong, you also stand up screaming at the face of the publisher, I killed you!
That's partly true.
Okay.
Not 100% accurate.
And our revealed aliens so far are Lorenzo, Hjalmar, and?
And there's one more.
And Luca.
Yes,
Luca.
Oh yes, Luca. Who was pretending not to be an alien real quick.
I will attack in H07.
Oh my god.
Oh my
so
god.
So let's see.
What?
Wait. Wait.
What?
You have to use an item.
What?
No, I don't have to use an item.
Oh, we got the power.
Okay, so...
No, he's the soldier.
Or maybe Luca is a human and Mario is an alien.
Oh, but how is this possible?
Oh my god!
If we're not an alien, what happened?
Or maybe we are all aliens.
Special power.
Guys, I'm not sure that I prepared the decks in the right way.
I missed one thing. Sorry.
Oh, yes.
I was changed to an alien.
Oh.
And you don't have to say it.
In the original prototype, the main way to play was not declaring used items. That's why we still have issues today between us in declaring items, because we played a long time not declaring them, which, to be honest, it's still our favorite way to play. Yeah, I think everybody agrees. But it led to some issues that did not feel comfortable to leave publishing in the original published game.
We have a special question. Can we have a Leaf Blower item card as a 10th anniversary promo? I think that's an amazing idea.
Approved. I am gonna attack S05. I'm dead!
What?
Luca! I told you Pietro was fishing up there.
I've never seen someone so happy screaming, I'm dead! Yeah!
Yes. I attack in E03.
No, come on!
What?
You there?
Really?
Yes!
I'm dead.
I think it tells something about what you think about humans, because when the aliens win, everyone wins, because everyone becomes an alien. But the humans are so selfish, you know?
Said the alien. Thank you, Hjalmar. Thank you very much.
It's really good about making friends.
To be honest, when we had to publish this game, we had some doubts about the victory conditions. After 10 years, I have to say that it's brilliant. And it's very original.
Thank you.
That's just because you won, Lorenzo. You're not fooling anyone.
Yeah, I won!
It's the brilliant. Yes.
You won!